Hi, everybody. Bob Carey. Thanks for checking in with us. It's been about 3 weeks since our last update. We've seen the market exhibit unusually high levels of volatility. We are up a little bit from where we were 3 weeks ago, but the fact is we had a pretty stiff correction right in the middle of this this period since our last update. It really tested a whole lot of people. In fact, investor sentiment and volatility indexes, all kinds of measures of fear, if you will, a couple of weeks ago were exactly where they were pretty much back in the middle of January when we had the sell-off that spooked so many investors. We are beginning to make some progress. In fact, we are starting to see the large institutional, we call them block share investors. They've actually been committing an awful lot of money to this market. They have been the net buyers, if you will, in this marketplace, and their influence on the market actually has been enough to basically offset the continued selling on the part of non-block share investors, which is a good proxy for mostly individual investors who remain cautious. In fact, have actually continued to pull money out of this market. And we've said since the beginning of the year that global developments are going to be important, and we are starting to see the price of oil begin to come back up a little bit. The dollar has softened a little bit. Credit spreads remain very, very wide, so we continue to have a lot of stress in the credit markets that are negatively affecting the companies in the high-yield space in particular. So the high-yield bond market remains quite volatile from a day-to-day perspective. However, when we take a step back and look at earnings estimates for this year, and we take a look at earnings that are coming in, we continue to believe that earnings will actually exhibit some pretty decent strength, especially as we get into the second and third quarters of 2016. As of right now, the bottom-up consensus earnings estimates imply growth of about 8% for the S&P 500 this year. So we've got an index that is down about 6% as I'm recording this here today, with earnings expected to be up 8% for the year. So there is a lot of potential for a rebound, and we do believe a rebound is underway at this point. We've had 11 companies out of the S&P report earnings so far this week. We'll continue to get more as time goes on, but we are effectively at the end of earnings reporting season for Q4, but 10 of those 11 companies have beaten earnings estimates, and the companies in particular that are in the retailing space are having the most success. It's beginning to get more obvious to us anyways that the consumer is starting to spend and spend at a much higher rate than many were anticipating here a couple of years ago, or even a couple of months ago for that matter. So the windfall from lower energy prices, continued gains in employment, longer work weeks, all that pretty much is telling us that the consumer is in pretty good shape in spite of the volatility that the market has experienced so far this year. So anyhow, buckle up. As I said last time, it's a rodeo, and you have to stay in and stay on to win, if you will. And we continue to feel the same way here on the 23rd of February of 2016. We'll talk to you later.